we all know the weather is warming up, so it's goodbye to the season for soups and stews. Winter actually feels like a bit of a distant memory at the moment. And what we need for summer is delicious fresh food. And we have Mark Jensen from Salmon and Bear Casual Seafood Eatery joining us today. Now, Mark, you are making something very fancy today. A salmon poke?
Salmon poke. Salmon poke. Exactly.
Pokes only happen on Facebook.
Exactly. That's what you do. People still do that on Facebook?
I'm not sure.
I'm not sure either.
But where does poke come from then?
Poke is Hawaiian. So it was a dish that developed. So it's a dish that developed to make the most of all the offcuts of really big fish like tuna, you know, so they get tuna. So it's cutting into little dice and then we're going to marinate it and serve it with salad and rice. So really just think about it as like
a sushi salad. Oh, fantastic.
Exactly.
Well, let's get cooking.
Let's do it. So there's no cooking involved, which is awesome. So you can just head down to the fish market, grab a nice piece of fish and have sort of lovely salad vegetables in your fridge at home. So do you see how I did that? This is an easy way to cut a capsicum.
Oh my gosh, look at that.
You roll it out.
Look at that.
Done. Done. It's very fancy. Look at that. It is. So, but it makes it really easy because what we want to do is dice things up. So if we do that, it's nice and straightforward. We can cut like that. Do a nice dice.
So, and when you're dicing, does everything sort of have to be around the same size?
Yeah,
is that the point?
Well, you know, it should
roughly.
Be.
Roughly.
But roughly, you know, I mean, everything should be. It's all about we eat with our eye. It should be kind of like that. Yeah. But look, anything goes, really. So
colourful.
What we want to do, exactly. So we're adding colour. So we've got the red capsicum. Again, we put some green through this.
No yellow capsicum?
No, well, you know, you could because I always say recipes are just that. They're just a bit of framework. So
that
you know,
is
you
so
just...
cool how you're doing that.
I know.
Is this not wasted?
Well, you know, you could actually trim that up and use that as well.
But you can't eat the white bit, can you?
No, not at all. Okay. So it's just a matter of, you know, it's always these simple little chefy tricks that really impress people because you're at home, you're struggling to do bits and pieces. And how easy is that? You're shown once and then that becomes...
That's so cool.
...a technique for life, right? Mm. So let's just make this really colourful. So we've got the red, we've got the green, making lots of mess here, which really works as well. So corn, so they're just really summer vegetables. You think of all these things, tomato, corn growing well. I've actually taken the liberty of char grilling this guy earlier.
How long does that take?
Because we can do that. So, well, I had to sort of boil this first, just for a couple of minutes, and then put it on the char grill. So, throw it on the barbie, perfect, because you don't want the heat to be too hot either, because it's just going to burn. So again, probably easy to cut that in half, and then it's all about safety. So a sharp knife is a safe knife. Does everyone know that?
Yeah.
Mm.
You always cut your fingers with a blunt knife.
Yeah,
and most
true.
People have blunt knives at home, right?
Yep.
So make sure they're nice and sharp.
Could you just get corn kernels out of the can, or would that be...
You what?
Barbarian. If you wanted to save some time.
Well,
you know.
It's all about time saving, is it? I guess you could. You could get them out of the can. They come frozen. This actually can be the ultimate convenience dish, you know.
Okay.
So.
I mean, you could buy the whole salad at the shop.
Well, you could.
I mean.
In a plastic bag.
Pete, I reckon you even get the fish guy to dice it for you, right? Dice the fish for me. So we've got that. We've got what else? We need some onion. Let's get some red onion going through here.
The red onion versus the white onion versus the brown onion, without going to big onion debate, what's the difference?
Well, I actually like the flavour of the red onion. It's a bit more lively and less of that sharpness that a brown or a white onion will give you. Mm. And that tends to be why you cook those onions out, because it just sort of mellows the flavour a little bit. So this is coming together nice and summer. My little mess here is coming together nicely as well. What else do I need? A tomato. Let's dice that.
And while you're cutting that up, can we talk through the marinade that we have here? Because it smells amazing. I could drink this. It's basically sesame oil and soy sauce.
That's exactly right. So it's right under your nose. But doesn't that smell
fantastic? Is it equal parts?
It's pretty much equal parts. And then we put some water in it to thin it out.
Yep.
And also add a little bit of sugar just to sweeten it off.
So, brown sugar?
Brown sugar is good.
Okay.
Yep, exactly. So we're just using those, you know, flavour profiles, the salt, sweet, you know, sour, bitter, all those sorts of things.
And if you were going to marinate your salmon, is it something you'd do overnight or can you just chuck it on for an hour?
What is really good about this is you don't have to do it very long at all.
Okay.
So let me just do this and then we'll move on to our fish. Because this fish is pretty special, you know. This is no ordinary salmon. Did you know that there's a couple of varieties of salmon? And this salmon that we use at Salmon and Bear is actually Ora King salmon, which is a Pacific salmon, and Pacific salmon only make up less than 1% of all the salmon in the world.
Oh.
It's actually known as the Wagyu of the sea because of
the
fat content in the fish. It actually tastes delicious.
Is it an expensive fish?
Well, I always say when you talk about food, it's all about value and quality. Mm. So, I mean, it possibly is a little bit more expensive, but then again, I mean, it's so high in omega-3s and all those really fantastic things for you. So it's just that it's worth it, I think, just paying that little bit more.
Right.
And you don't have to eat so much, right? So,
but normal salmon's fine at a pinch, isn't it?
Well, normal salmon's fine at a pinch as well.
Right.
I mean, yes, you can get it out of a can even, I guess. I wouldn't recommend it. We'd never do that at Salmon and Bear. No way. When it's fresh is best for us.
Right.
So what I want to do now is take the skin off. So these are lovely portions that we have there.
Mm-hmm.
So
it's
just
easy.
Take the skin off like so. Then always find if you break things down into smaller portions, like big chunks like that, it's just easier for you to work with.
Are you going to slice along the line?
Yeah,
oh,
no,
against the grain.
Against the grain. Well, it's like beef.
Is it?
So, well, you know how you slice across the grain to get so it's nice and tender, so you expose all
Know that.
Did you?
No.
You and I should do a cooking class together.
We should
together.
Do a cooking class.
Oh, actually, I should conduct the cooking class, and you should come
there.
Along.
Absolutely.
Yeah, exactly. So let's get a bowl to marinate this in. How about I take this one?
Sure.
Get this. So nice little fine dice we've got going on here.
This is perfect for now that we're moving into the summer. This is what you want, away from the heavy foods, isn't it?
Absolutely. This is the ultimate summer dish. And, I mean, you know, Australians love their seafood and we're so blessed to have so much fantastic stuff available. Mm. And who doesn't like going and casting a fishing line on the weekend?
Yeah.
I'm sure you're doing that, right?
It's funny. I used to be not a fish fan at all, especially raw fish.
Mm-hmm.
But there's something about salmon. It's just it doesn't have that really overtly fishy taste.
Yeah.
It's a very delicate.
Yeah. Well, since it's an imported species, right? Salmon doesn't exist in our waters here in Australia. So we actually grow that down in Tasmania, or we import it from New Zealand or North America.
Yeah, right.
And considering that no one really ate salmon 20 years ago, it's now the most popular go-to fish
that
people eat.
And it's easy to cook with.
It's amazing. Well, it is. I mean, I think because it's got that oil content, it's hard to overcook. Even when you cook it right through, it's still kind of juicy and feels tastes great, right? So, back here. So that's all we do. We dice it. And then we have this lovely marinade.
Throw that on.
And we put that on.
How brilliant. And how long would you do this for? Would you keep it in the fridge or keep it room temp?
You could... This salad is perfect to eat room temp. But, I mean, obviously it's seafood, so we have to keep it in the fridge and, you know, play by all those food safety rules, which is cool. But when you're about to sort of form the salad and put it all together, I'd actually pull it out of the fridge for about 15 minutes just to bring the temperature up a little bit.
All right.
Because, you know, you bite into an ice cream, that's cool, that's what you expect. But if you bite into things like this, you kind of want it to be more room temperature so you can actually taste the flavours.
That makes sense.
Yeah.
We have the fantastic Mark Jensen here, who has been showing us how to make a delicious salmon poke. Which is essentially a salmon salad, right?
A sushi salad. Just
sushi
think of
salad.
It as sushi salad, and everyone can go for it.
All right. So we've been marinating our salmon for a few minutes over the break.
Exactly. So 10 to 15 minutes.
Yep.
So if I'm, you know, sushi, so we need rice, right? Mm. So at Salmon and Bear, we use basmati rice because it's really sort
basmati.
Of basmati. Yeah, yeah.
I always call it basmati.
Yeah. Well, you know, I call basmati. You say basmati.
Yeah.
You know,
let's call the whole thing off.
So, <yeah. laughs> Thanks for that. But I like because it's low GI, so, I mean, it's all about healthy living, right?
Ooh,
so
yeah.
Let's do that.
And
so
you can get it in a bag as well.
Exactly.
I
convenience again. So we've got rice.
Right.
We have salad, our lovely sort of corn salsa license. So doesn't it look fantastic? Like summer, right?
Colourful.
It's summer.
It does.
Colourful. We add our salmon.
And you stir. Like you stir before you put it in.
No, that's exactly right. Well, it's all smoke and mirrors, really. You just got to get it in the bowl.
Yeah.
Okay, so look, that is looking awesome already. So what I need now is avocado. Yeah, exactly. This is why people can't afford houses, right?
Yeah,
okay, let's get...
Only if you smash it, though, as long as you okay.
This one's okay. Oh, I didn't do that so well, but you get
that
the idea,
beautiful.
Right? So it's coming together nice. So let that just screaming summer. So now we have a little secret. short little thing at Salmon and Bear that we use, and we call this our poke crunch. So it has seaweed in there, it has fried shallots, and it has those little fish called anchovies, but they're dried and fried, so they're nice and salty, and they're totally awesome. So let's finish that. It's the ooh and the ah moment, isn't it? Yeah. And then, of course, we need some lemon. So it's that acid that just really sets flavours off. So if you're stuck for flavour, even if you're cooking a steak, I know we're not talking about steak, but finish it with lemon, salt and pepper. Bam, like the barbecue. It just brings those flavours up and it's totally awesome.
And can I ask, Mark, would you prepare this salmon slowly or is it salmon rusty?
I've heard that joke like three times this week. Yeah. You keep trying to make it fly, don't you?
You keep pulling on the salmon, people, you know.
Like, yummy!
But doesn't it look fantastic?
It's a great Hawaiian dish. Let's get into it. Unfortunately, I can't because I'm pregnant. I can't eat fish.
Of course. Please, I don't know who. But you know what? Can I do one thing? You know, best way to eat this, it looks great. You present it to the table, it looks awesome. Mm. But the best way to eat it is actually to mesh it all up.
Gumbo. I know you've made it look. Work.
It made it look fantastic, but you want to combine all those flavours. And away you go. Let's look. Why not?
Oh, you put a bit of drizzle.
You need a drizzle. It's a cooking segment, so you need a drizzle.
A bit of drizzle.
A little bit
drizzle.
More crunch. There you go.
Mark Jensen, you can find Mark's amazing recipes in his cookbook, The Urban Cook, or you can get his delicious meals at Salmon and Bear at Zetland or Newtown in Sydney.